Soccer's just a game, but it's bigger than that, because God uses it to change people's lives. It's a world stage, a language that we speak, but not for the sake of hearing our own voices or seeking our own glory. It's a common ground and a shared space, a place we can tell the nation some of our story. And this is what we speak, not in words taught to us by men, but in words taught to us by God. We're meant to be all things to everyone, to tell as many people as we can that Christ has come to bring abundant life. And this is our language wherever we play. The game is the game. The rules don't change. In Africa, a goal is a goal as long as it crosses the line between the posts, even if the entire village is on the field. Taking the ball from your side to theirs, beating the Myanmar national team defenders, the crowd still cheers. Thailand and Ireland and whatever land you happen to be in, a goal is always celebrated because it's unique and new each time. And a save is a save, and a PK spot is still 36 feet away in Latin South and North America. We play hard, get hit hard, and hit hard. And a foul's a foul on grass, dirt, or clay, no matter what time, what day, what venue you play. If you get beat, it's part of the game. A meg's a meg as long as it goes through your legs. And when it's all said and done, when it's the end of the day, we play not for the love of the game, but for the love of the one whose name we praise. We have a great commission, a love-filled mission, to take it to the kids who know so little of it. Cause kids are kids wherever you go, playing the game with whatever they have available, even if it's just a ball made of plastic or rope. Around the world or here at home, they're drawn to us, they come to us, and we know there's hope that they can change the world if they believe and look to Christ alone. And do you believe that you can be used to change the face of your family, your community, your tribe, people, or nation? Because to whom much is given, much is required. Who can you build up, disciple, touch, help, or inspire? And because this language transcends agendas, we send out men and women to love on our nation and all nations affected by the same cancer of secularism, materialism, of corruption, hate, greed, and terrorism, racism, and sexism, and strongholds hostile to our commission. Let's start our movement, or join one that's moving. Let's be a people with a heart for the broken and the wounded. So use the one language, the one you speak, and join in the one mission, the one we've all been commissioned to undertake.